Now the pale morning sings of forgotten things. She plays the tune for those who wish to overlook the fact that they've been blindly deceived by those who preach and pray and teach. But she falls short and the night explodes in laughter. Don't you come here and say I didn't warn you about the way your world can alter. And oh, how you try to command it all still. Every single time it all shifts one way or the other. And I'm a goddamn coward, but then again, so are you.
The Joker. Seems about right. Feels like another record cold snap on the way. I'd better get a fire going before the pipes freeze up again. Great Bear Island. Dad used to fly there all the time. He said it used to be beautiful. Not much reason to go there these days, since the quakes and all. Ah, a rare McKenzie family photo. Miss you, Dad. Those were better days. Jackrabbit remote transport. Zero flights a day to the mainland communities and, well, anywhere, really. Getting pretty late in the day. Guess I could take a nap. I don't remember needing my parka this early in the season. It seems to get colder every year. Well, here we are, old girl. Your best flights may be behind you, but you're still beautiful to me. And anyways, you're all I've got. I'd sure love to give you one last great adventure. Right. Pipes froze up again. That be? Jackrabbit Remote Transport, Mackenzie speaking.
I told her not to come up. I told her you couldn't fly in this weather. For once, will you not be so damn stubborn?
Well, slow down, Maureen. What are you talking about?
She just showed up. Said you'd see her. Said you'd fly her north. I know you need the money. The weather service...
It's okay, Maureen. I've got it from here.
Hello, Will.
What are you doing here?
It's been a while, I know.
Yeah. Years. I haven't heard from you since...
I know. And I wouldn't be here if it weren't important.
Well, what brings you... I mean, are you sick?
No. No, not me. But I need to get to someone who is.
Right. So you're still a doctor?
Yes, I'm still a doctor.
I thought that after... Why are you here?
I need your help. There's an isolated community in the northern part of Great Bear. Someone there is very sick.
Great Bear? There's nothing there anymore. Not since...
I know. But I have to get there.
Still trying to save the world, huh?
Somebody has to.
What's that supposed to mean?
Mackenzie, Will, I didn't come here to fight about the past. I need a pilot to take me somewhere remote. Someone who won't ask too many questions. Someone I can trust.
Wait, questions? Astrid, are you in trouble?
Are you gonna help me, or not?
What's in the case?
See, there's that thing about no questions, remember?
What's in the case, Astrid?
No questions.
Look, the weather out there is bad. Bad. I mean, it's getting worse. You walk in here after years. I could have been dead. You could have been. And then you show up and you want me to just risk my life flying into the middle of the great northern nowhere to deliver you and some mystery metal case to some remote wilderness outpost, all because you walked in here and asked me to?
Yes.
Astrid, you can't bring him back.
This isn't about that.
I know how hard it's been.
No. You don't know, Mackenzie. You don't know... anything.
You don't think I feel it too?
Are you gonna take me or not? The longer I wait, the worse it'll get. Damn it. I don't have time for this.
Wait. The worse what will get? Why do I have a feeling you're not talking about the weather?
Because I'm not.
Throw your bags in the plane. I'll get started on pre-flight. Better buckle up tight, because it's gonna be a rough ride. Let's see. Two people plus enough fuel to get us out to Great Bear and back leaves. Almost no capacity for cargo. If we're too heavy, we'll burn through our fuel before we get there. I'll have to be careful about what else I take with me. The mysterious case. Astrid's traveling pretty light. Wherever she's going, she must not be planning to stay long. Just need to grab my parka and we can go. Astrid's a doctor, so we're covered there. But the distress pistol kit is heavy. I'd hate to end up in an emergency situation without it.
You're still wearing it.
Wearing what?
Your ring. Our ring.
Oh. Yeah. I mean, I just forgot to take it off.
I wear mine too.
Why?
Memories, I guess.
I thought you wanted to forget.
Not all of it.
Look. I should have looked for you.
It's okay. I've kept busy. I've moved on.
You sure? Because this all seems pretty familiar. You still working with that researcher, Doctor? What's his name?
No. No, I'm not working at the center anymore.
Well, then where?
I'm working on my own. Freelance, you could say.
Freelance doctor? That sounds legit.
I don't question your life choices, Mackenzie. Plenty of things you could be doing besides hanging out in your dad's old plane and drinking in the daytime.
Hey, we had a lot of good times in this plane. And it's under control.
I know, okay? I'm not here to fight, really.
I think about him all the time, you know?
I know you do.
What I did. The choice I made. I did it.
for us.
You don't have to. Mud's just not...
No. It's important that you hear this. There's things I need to
Mackenzie,
say.
Mackenzie, not now. There's...
Just let me tell you.
Will, shut up for a second. Something's wrong.
That is not good.
What's going on?
Power's gone. Whole electrical system looks fried.
Shit! What's happening?
No power means we're going down. Hold tight.
Will?
Astrid? Astrid! I must have gone right through the windshield. Trees broke my fall. Oh, mostly. Gotta stop. Come on. I don't feel so good. I need to rest up. Thank you.
bastard hasn't come looking for me. Which means she can't come looking for me. Because she's hurt. Or worse. I'd better get back up to the crash site.
Did it?